Good morning, everyone. So today I'll be filming another day in the life of a tax manager. I'll be going into the office today because we're actually getting some really nice weather today. It is currently 7:17 and I am going to be heading out now to commute. But before I do that, I just wanted to jump in and let you guys know what I've been up to. So in the morning, I woke up at 6:30 a.m. I got ready. I actually put in some effort today, which has been a really long time because usually I just roll out of bed and then put on some sweats and then get to work. But then today, since I'm going into the office, I decided to put in a little bit more effort. I dressed up. It's a little bit chilly now that it's starting to become more fall. So I put on this sweater and then I put on this vest thing to make it look a little bit more formal, and it's just super comfortable as well. So anyway, so I'm gonna be heading out and I'll show you guys what I do today. Also, a side note, I don't know if you guys know this, but my sister is actually a tax lawyer and she's been going into the office every single day during the weekday, and she's pretty isolated in her office, so she is required to go into the office for a couple of months until she gets her training in. She just finished her articling, so she is now a full-fledged lawyer, and so she's getting training and she's going to the office. Today I'm going to be commuting with her, and I don't know if she wants to be in the video or not. She likes to keep, you know, pretty private and she doesn't like to be in the videos, but well, maybe I'll get some snippets of what we do together if we end up, you know, grabbing lunch. Just wanted to, you know, throw it out there that I might not be alone today. So our bus got delayed, so we're just waiting here a little bit. Once I go into the office, I'm gonna be getting some work done related to US busy season. I have some tax returns that I need to review that's been sort of sitting on my plate, so hopefully I'll get through those and maybe I'll have some really good lunch. I don't know where to go for lunch today. I'll think about it. But one of those things of going to work in downtown is getting to choose what you want to have for lunch if you end up buying. And so since I go only once in a while, it's a little bit of a treat for me to buy my lunch. So I'm gonna think of what I want. Maybe my sister will join me, maybe she won't. So we'll see. And so I guess lunch is up in the air right now. Into the office, I've set up, made myself comfortable, unpacked and everything. It is currently 8:25, so a little bit before 9, and I thought I would make myself a simple breakfast similar to last time. I brought my bread and I brought my avocado, so it's just gonna be a very simple avocado toast for my morning, and then I'll be getting or I'll be buying something for lunch, so I'll show you guys. There's no cups today. So, and then maybe some salt and pepper. So today there doesn't seem to be any cutlery or cups. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna grab coffee instead downstairs and then hopefully grab some cutlery as well. Perfect, thank you so much.
Thank you, have a good day.
Thank you, you too. So I decided to get my morning coffee, which you guys saw, and then the person at the front was so nice that she gave me fork and knives for my breakfast, and then so now I'm just gonna proceed with making my breakfast. Oh, I should probably toast my bread, so I'll be right back. Okay, so I'm back, just making my breakfast right now. So today I do have a full schedule. We are currently in US tax busy season. Oh my gosh, my hair looks crazy. Okay, there we go. We are currently in US tax busy season right now. So I do have a couple of returns that are sitting for my review, and I don't like to be that bottleneck where people are waiting for me to review to get their work done. So usually when things come in, I like to kind of, you know, multitask and work on multiple files. And if there's any questions, I like to send those off first so that at least they get worked on, whether that's like being sent to the client or have certain issues be updated by the junior. So I'd like to kind of work on multiple things so that they're not sitting with me too long. So usually when something's ready for my review, a junior sends me a message or sends me an email listing the links to the document center or the document system that we have of all the documents or the returns that are ready for my review. And so what I tend to do is I would go in, I would look at the work paper, which is in Excel. I would check all the tabs, the main tab being all the tax adjustments and seeing if they're being supported appropriately. And if we have the right supports in place, then I would go through the TB, the trial balance, which is basically a more detailed version of the profit or loss or income statement. I would go through that and see if we have missed anything. There are certain items that are tax adjustments that we're familiar with. Like for example, if you see meals, that's only 50% deductible. Anything that's related to entertainment, that's not deductible. So you would have to add that back. But then, you know, other expenses like salary or office supplies, those are, you know, standard deductions. And if there's any new accounts, we would follow up with the client because usually the accounts are very vague, so we don't know what they're related to, and we wanna make sure that we capture everything. The clients that I usually work with are very diverse. We have some clients in the financial sector, I have one in the mining sector, I have another one in kind of like IT sector, like SaaS. And so I get a very like diverse group of clients. It's not like the Canadian tax group where, you know, since we're in Canada, we're more kind of focused on Canadian tax. So they have a lot of different groups that focus on different components of Canadian tax, like mining, like PCS or private client services, what else, like just corporate general tax, stuff like that. But then in US tax, since we're in Canada, it's more, you know, it's not as big. And so our US group basically does everything. And within the US group, you might have some specializations, but then generally people wear multiple hats in the US group. So we kind of work on all different kinds of clients in different industries. Okay, so I finished making my breakfast. So I'm just having my breakfast right now. And my coffee, I haven't had coffee in a while because I feel like it makes me a little jittery even if I have one cup of coffee in the morning. And I feel like for coffee, you grow immune to it almost if you drink too much. I know some people drink like 5 cups of coffee a day. I don't know how they do it, or even drink coffee before bed. I would not be able to sleep at all if I had coffee that late. But 1 in the morning usually kind of sets my mood. It puts me in a good mood and also sets my mind into like work mode, and I tend to focus really well. So what I'm doing right now, it's 8:50, just planning what my day is. I usually like to kind of know what I'm working on today instead of just jumping into work. And I have right in front of me that I can't show you is my timesheet. So something that you need to do in public practice is keep track of your time that is spent on all your different clients. And the thing with tax that might be a little bit of a con, depends on how you see it, is since we work on so many different files, we need to keep track of different files and how much time we spend on them. So in a day, you might be working on like 4 to 5 different clients. Yesterday, I could see that I was working on 1, 2, 3, 4 different files at the same time. And so you just kind of go back and forth. And I like to keep track of my time on Excel, as well as the progress and the timeline of the different files. I have in front of me multiple clients, and some of my bigger clients that have like 30 different states, I've actually managed to review most of them. So I feel a little bit better about them. There's one that had 30, I think, yeah, there's one that had 30 states that being sent to the client, and the client hasn't gone back to us with their review. They've just been super behind, but you know, we're still a month before the deadline. So I feel okay about that. We're still ahead of schedule. And then I have smaller returns that I've kind of let my juniors run. And now that they're ready for my review, I'll be taking a look at them, but I don't see them taking too long of a time. So my schedule today is to review one return that came in. It's a smaller return, it's one federal and one state, but
we did the tax provision, so I don't foresee anything too drastic when I am looking at the return. And then I am still waiting on a couple of juniors. So the juniors right now are a little bit of a bottleneck because they just ended the September 15th deadline. And so they've been really preoccupied with that. And a lot of things are sitting on them. Sometimes what I like to do as a manager, because sometimes we know the workflow is the juniors work on something, and then once it's ready, then it comes to us. So it gets filtered. But for me, sometimes if I just want to move things along, I would just review from what we've outsourced to India. So it's already been prepared. The juniors usually do the filtering to make sure it's up to par, and then it gets sent to me. Sometimes I just review what's being prepared and kind of skip the juniors to kind of help them alleviate their workload. And then once I have some review notes, I get the juniors to clear them. So it kind of moves things along. It also makes me feel better knowing that I've taken a look at something and that there aren't any major issues that I picked up. And the worst thing is, you know, when it's getting close to the deadline and it's ready for your review, but then you see so many issues that, you know, there is not much of a time frame to go back to the client, discuss with the partner, discuss with the director to resolve it. So sometimes I would just skip that and just look at the returns and high level to see if there's anything, any big issues. So I'm gonna be taking my vitamins since I just had breakfast. I have this little tiny cute container that has all my vitamins. I've been taking vitamins for a very long time. I feel like they're very important because depending on, you know, what your needs are, every person is different. You might be lacking in certain nutrients, or you might wanna be taking more of certain nutrients depending on, you know, obviously what your body's needs are. For me, I like to take supplements to do with like hair and skin, as well as some vitamins related to improving my eyes, because I use a lot of my eyes for work. Obviously my eyes get really dry, they tend to be more on the sensitive side, so I like to take some supplements that, you know, help with my eyes. And then also like other typical supplements that are supposed to be really good for you, like omega-3 as well as probiotics. I adjusted my table. The good thing about working in the office is that all the tables are adjustable, so you could lift them up or lift them down depending on, you know, your height and what's comfortable for you. What I like to do is to have a lower table but then higher monitors, so they're supposed to be at the level where your eyes could see at the, you know, the, I would say, 1/3 of the screen. So make sure that all your screens are propped up, but then at the same time, you don't want to be typing like this with your desk too high. I like to have more of a 90 degree angle when I type, and so that keeps your shoulders relaxed, and that's supposed to be like more of the ideal kind of posture. Make sure that your seat is also adjusted so that your feet are on the ground. It's surprising how many people just like have their feet kind of dangle, or they prop their feet against the leg of the chair, but then you want to have your feet flat against the ground and then your knees at a 90 degree angle. So I like to, you know, maintain a good posture, because a lot of the work that we do, we're sitting at the desk all day and we're sitting all day, and so it's important to maintain a good posture so that you don't feel any pain later down the line with your back, your shoulders, your lower back, you know, your legs, etc. So that's something that people don't really take into consideration until years into your career. You know, obviously for me, I've been working for 7+ years, and so I'm used to working at a desk, but you could forget sometimes that you are constantly sitting down. So another good reminder is to have some sort of fit watch. I like to have this one because it's very thin and comfortable on my wrist, and what it does is every like 30 minutes, every 1 hour, it would just give me an alert to stand up and to stretch. So then what I would do is in the middle of working, I would just kind of stand up, give myself a little stretch, and then go back to work. And those little breaks are really important to let your body relax, because while you're working, you could be super tense. One thing I've noticed that I tend to do is as I work, I tend to lift my shoulders more and more and become really tense. But then when I get that alert, it reminds me to relax, to stretch it out. And so it kind of goes back to, you know, my normal posture until over time it starts getting tense again. So a little tip for those who are just starting to work and are getting used to sitting at a desk, to, you know, have proper posture, or, oh my God, that's like a tongue twister. Try to maintain proper posture as well as be reminded to get up once in a while so that you can stretch.
So it's currently 11 a.m. and all I can think is lunch. So I'm just seeing what are good restaurants nearby, because I'm actually going to be grabbing lunch with my sister. I'll be treating her out, but I want to get something really good. There is a really nice Japanese restaurant, or like a fusion Japanese restaurant near where I work, but they're fully booked. Okay, so I thought of a different place to go to that is perfect and that's what I'm in the mood for. So I made a reservation, called my sister. She's gonna be meeting me nearby so we could walk over together. It's just fun to have my sister work in downtown, even though I don't get the chance to work in downtown often, because, you know, sometimes I feel like working at home and I just come to the office once in a while. But you know, it's just one of those things where I imagined before COVID time, when my sister gets a job in downtown and I work in downtown, we could meet up, we could go for lunches, we could go for happy hours after work. But it's just unfortunate that we weren't able to do that very often. Actually, this is gonna be our first time. Yeah, I'm excited to grab lunch later and see where that goes.
So I decided to take a quick tour of our lobby, which is really nice. So I'm currently at the very top floor of our office, and it's the nicest floor because you could see basically the whole ocean view, and also it's where we meet our clients, so it's a little bit nicer. So I just wanted to show you guys around because I don't really usually go to this floor, but because I have some time, I'm just gonna show you.
So this is the waiting room, and you could see that the view is really nice from here. You could see the whole ocean view as well. Let me see if I could get a little closer. Yep, so the whole ocean view, and then you have the view of downtown, and then the waiting room. I was just sitting there.
So it's pretty empty right now because I don't think there are many clients coming into the office to meet, because a lot of the people, or a lot of the employees, are working from home. It's pretty empty here. Like, I'm the only one here right now, so I could film a little bit more freely.
These are the meeting rooms. You can see that all the chairs are blocked off, or some of the chairs are blocked off. And then you can see the view from here. It usually impresses the clients when they come here. There's also this other side with a bunch of meeting rooms. It's massive. Like, this could turn into one big room. And you can see that here, let me go in and show you guys. So this is one big meeting room. And also a lot of people, or a lot of teams, kind of get together for group meetings. So these rooms come in handy. We just haven't been able to use them in a while because nobody's in the office. And then there's more meeting rooms down there. So I'm just gonna go back to the lobby. So this is the outfit of the day. I just have a sweater on because it was pretty chilly today. And then I have this vest. It's pretty long and it's really comfortable. It has pockets, which are the best. And then I kind of have just like leggings on, and then I have my runners. So it's kind of casual, but kind of formal at the same time. I'm walking over to meet my sister. So I'm just waiting for my sister right now. It's quite sunny outside today, but I forgot my sunglasses, which I'm kind of like choked about, but you know, it's okay. We're having for lunch?
The Japanese food?
Yeah. Do you know Gyu?
Oh, really?
Yeah. There's one here that I used to go to all the time. It's pretty good. So I made reservations and everything, but it was a total fail because my sister forgot her ID card. But right now, we need a vaccine card and an ID card, but she forgot it. So we decided to take out and we're just gonna sit near the water and eat outside, which is, you know, not bad.
So we ordered sushi because we're going to be eating outside, but in the meantime we ordered bubble tea, so it's like the perfect lunch. I'm really excited because I'm like starving right now because of someone forgot their ID. Okay, so I got my food. Look how much there is. I ordered a lot. And then bubble tea.
We just decided to eat outside here because it's pretty sunny out, so we found a spot in the shade, and then this is our food. Looks really good, and then we have somewhat of a view behind us. Oh, it's really, really windy right now.
Takoyaki. This one looks pretty good, the salad. What are you doing?
I got an avocado salad. I got two popular rolls, and then takoyaki and gome. Lawyers don't know how to use Excel. We decided to move seats because it was kind of chilly there. We just have, oops, here, I'll show you guys. So we just had some leftover food. We're just enjoying our bubble tea, and then the view is really nice. Okay, so I just finished lunch with my sister and I'm gonna go back to work. I have some leftover food because we order a lot. So back to the grind. I realized that the gym is open. Here, I'm gonna check it out. Bring my workout clothes next time so I could actually work out at the gym here. It's pretty nice. Totally forgot about it.
So I just came back from lunch. I had a good time with my sister. We got to sit outside and eat outside because she forgot her ID card. Oops, that's my computer. So right now there is this new rule in place where you need to have your vaccination card in order to go into certain indoor spaces like restaurants and gyms, and you not only need your QR code, but you also need a photo ID so that they can match the ID with the QR code, which is, you know, I think a little bit extreme, but whatever needs to be done to keep the population safe, I guess. And so we just decided to order takeout instead and sit outside, and that was nice itself. We were able to kind of think on our feet and have a change of plans. Anyways, now that I'm back, I am about to start work, but one thing that I look forward to every single Wednesday is this post or this email that I get from one of my really close friends from work, and it will actually be his last week this week, which is pretty sad because I feel like now everyone in my peer group or around my peer group has left, so I think almost the only one left. Maybe there's a few, just one or two of us, but he's someone that I'm really close with, and he sends me these midweek motivations. And right now, the one he sent me is issue number 78, which means that he's been sending me these midweek motivations for over a year, like almost a year and a half. And they're pretty funny. They're something that I look forward to every Wednesday, and it kind of just lifts my mood up and keeps you motivated, as the name mentions, midweek motivation. So, and this is going to be his last week. So this is going to be the last the last issue that I received from his work email. Yeah, it's pretty funny. I won't share though, because sometimes there's more inside jokes. But if I were to give you a little bit of a sneak peek, so I'm gonna maybe just share my reaction reading through it. I won't show you the actual email though. Oh my god. Oh my goodness. He also included some photos of us, like, I don't know, 6-7 years ago. I think it's 7 years ago. Oh my gosh. And we used to have these really awesome Christmas parties at our firm. It's one of the biggest and most well-known Christmas parties in Vancouver, I like to think. It was pretty all out, like the firm goes all out for Christmas parties. We rent this huge venue. There's like a buffet style with all kinds of food. Also, I think it's unlimited alcohol, like an open bar. Not too sure, maybe it was drink tickets, but I always remember having unlimited drinks, and we would have a really good time there, especially when we were just starting out at the firm and we were taking advantage of all the different work perks out there. And so yeah, some crazy photos from those times.
There's a little snack section. I grabbed some for myself here, and I'm gonna have some tea.
Hey guys, so just checking in here. It is currently 6 p.m. and I'm gonna call it a day. I wrapped up all the files that I wanted to wrap up today. There was one federal and state return, which was relatively simple, I would say. There weren't many changes from the provision time, and the senior on the file did a really good job, so there weren't really much review notes, and I sent that to the partner for a final review. And so that's one crossed off my list. And then another one that I reviewed today were some combined state returns for this big IT company, which I managed to get done, and I've sent it back to the junior to make some updates and changes. And once that comes back to me, I'll just check if all the updates were made correctly, and then I'll probably forward that to the senior manager on the file so that she could look it over before we send it to the client. So I managed to get those done today, so I feel pretty accomplished. And I think I'm going to head out now. I cleaned up, as you can see, it's all cleaned up, and my bag is all ready to go. So yeah, let's get going.